What's up everyone and welcome back to TV Box Stop, the channel for the best reviews in TV boxes and accessories. Well, today I have a featured product that would be of interest to persons looking for the ultimate way to capture video for live streaming and creating HD and 4K videos from devices such as gaming consoles, streaming devices and even gaming PCs. This is the AverMedia Live Gamer 4K 2.1 PCIe capture card. Many of you have asked me in the past what software I use to capture video in 4K quality to use in my videos, and I would usually reply by saying, I don't use software, I use hardware. Well, in this video, you will see firsthand the hardware that I use, its latest HDMI 2.1 4K model with new hardware, faster performance, and how it caters for all your 4K video creation, gaming, and live streaming needs. So stay with me as I explore this amazing product that begins right after this. Welcome back. AverMedia is one of, if not the top manufacturer of gaming and streaming capture cards, and I would like to give special thanks to their team for sending their top products for review. So here I have their 4K PCIe line of products. This is the first generation Live Gamer 4K GC573 model, and this is the one I've been using for the past 5 years. It captures up to 4K 60Hz with HDR display. It has HDCP protection and it uses PCIe 3.0. It has HDMI 2.0 input and output ports with RGB light and effects. However, it cannot process Dolby Atmos, DTS audio or Dolby Vision formats. Since then, we have not had a new PCIe model till today with the advent of HDMI 2.1, and what the importance of 2.1 we'll get to in just a moment. This is their budget model and it's a bit of a step forward from the GC573 model, and it's called the Live Streamer Ultra HD GC571. And it captures up to 4K 30Hz maximum and has 4K 60Hz HDR and variable refresh rate pass-through. It's compatible with PCIe 3.0x1 port and uses the same HDMI 2.0 input and output port as the GC573 model. It's got no RGB lighting effects, and in this video I'll do an overview of what it can and cannot do in terms of audio and video capture and pass-through capabilities. And thirdly, this is the premium star product called the Live Gamer 4K 2.1 GC575 capture card. This latest model adopts the new HDMI 2.1 standard. It's compatible with both PCI Express 3.0 and 4.0 ports, captures up to 4K 60Hz and has 4K 144Hz pass-through. It has RGB lighting effects, HDR display and a variable refresh rate pass-through. Whether it's compatible with Dolby and DTS formats will be determined in just a moment. You might be wondering, what's this in this tall box here? Well, this is their AverMedia branded mousepad called Elena. If you go to their Amazon sales page, you will see that it comes bundled with the Ultra HD GC751 model, and it's also sold separately. So I'll start with the premier product, which is the Live Gamer 4K 2.1. The installation process is pretty straightforward. You simply find an available PCI Express 3.0 or 4.0 slot on your motherboard to insert it. It can be mounted horizontally in the standard position, or it can be mounted vertically using a PCI Express riser. This way, it gives you a better view of the card and its RGB lighting effects. Connecting to your streaming or gaming device and your display is also straightforward. The input from your device goes into the input port of the card, and the output HDMI port from the card goes to your display. So now that I've installed it successfully, there is one thing I would like to bring to your attention, and that is I found that installing it on a PCIe 4.0 slot is better than a 3.0 because I experienced some glitches when trying to capture at higher resolutions. When I switched to PCIe 4.0, it was very stable. To begin using the card, there are two apps that you need to download and install from the AverMedia support page: a game utility app and the other is the main app called RE Central or Record Central. The utility app is where you can view the card's current display information and HDCP settings. There is a section to configure its RGB lighting feature, and a settings area where you can perform software and firmware updates, and a section to configure its video source input setting. Record Central, as mentioned, is the main app that you use to either record, live stream, or multi-stream your live video or gameplay. Below here, if you are recording from a streaming device, camera, or other media player, here you can configure the recording quality of the video. You can create multiple presets for quick access. However, you will find that the maximum resolution at which you can record is 3840 by 2160p at 60Hz. You can also record a video in HDR format. This will, however, create very large files but in very high quality. Also, at any time during a recording session or live stream, you can click the camera button to take a screenshot without interrupting the stream. For live streaming, you can add each of your favorite streaming platforms with your login credentials and save them for easy access. This allows you to either live stream yourself using your camera, run a video, or play a game and live stream yourself simultaneously. Or if you would like to stream to multiple streaming platforms at the same time, you can do so under the multi-stream section, which allows you to add multiple platforms. If you click the settings button, this is where you can configure your audio input sources, such as from mics, webcams, and even audio generated on the desktop of your computer. On the left panel is where you can configure where your captured footage is saved for each project. You can configure keyboard shortcuts. You can import and export your profiles for backup. And there's an about section. Below here is where you can enable or disable HDCP protection and view the card's firmware driver and PCIe information. If you go back to the main panel, there's a section where you can view its input source information, and you can also manually control the input source, especially if the device that it's connected to does not have a display output configuration. As mentioned in the intro, what makes this capture card a premier product is that it's compatible with your PS4, PS5, Xbox, and other gaming consoles that uses the new HDMI 2.1 port. With this card, you get HDMI 2.1 pass-through to your 4K gaming monitors at 3840 by 2160p up to 144Hz with a G-Sync and variable refresh rate. If you go to the PlayStation 5 webpage, you will see that the specification states that it outputs 4K 120Hz via HDMI 2.1 protocol with variable refresh rate. This means all previous AVerMedia capture cards will work with your PS5 on HDMI 2.0 ports, but the video pass-through will be limited to 4K 60Hz and not 120Hz. So here under input source, it's receiving 4K 2160p at 144Hz, and this passes through to my monitor. As you can see, it displays 144Hz on the on-screen display overlay. It can also do 1440p at 144Hz and 1080p at 144Hz.
The fans helped them narrow it down, and with dinosaurs all over the silver screen, it helped tilt things towards the Raptors.
And we all remember those early uniforms.
And to start capturing or streaming your video or gameplay, simply hit the record or stream button. So I'll now record a short 4K 60Hz clip from this gameplay.
Good, and it's Russell picking up the assist.
When Russell gets his teammates involved, it makes this entire team better, and it'll make him more effective at the point position.
Lowry finds Gasol. Back to Lowry.
And this is the 4K 60Hz video quality you get from this capture card.
Team better, and it'll make him more effective at the point position.
Lowry finds Gasol. Back to Lowry.
So there you have it, and that's how I capture content in 4K quality for my videos. Its inability to capture in 4K 144Hz can be listed as a caveat, but in reality, most streaming platforms reduce the quality of your uploaded video, no matter the quality, to 4K 30Hz for general viewing. They maintain the original quality of the video on their servers, but downscale to 30Hz for smooth playback, as streaming in 4K 144Hz or even 8K would require a huge amount of bandwidth from the average user to play without constant buffering. I also connected the output of the capture card to my surround sound AV receiver, and the receiver receives audio, but it's not in Dolby or DTS format, but in PCM format. So as promised, I'll now do an overview of the second HDMI 2.0 model called the AVerMedia Live Ultra HD GC571. The second model does not have HDMI 2.1 compatibility. It uses the same new software as the 4K HDMI 2.1 model, but it's limited to 2160p up to 30Hz capture, and it's also limited to 2160p up to 60Hz pass-through to your displays. It does not have RGB lighting effects, but it does support variable refresh rate. So viewers, you finally have an insight into how I record my 4K content, and for the owners of the latest gaming consoles such as the PS5, Xbox X Series, and other popular gaming consoles, you now have a way to capture your live gaming or streams directly on your PC using HDMI 2.1. If you don't need HDMI 2.1 and just want to capture streams in HD or 4K, then you can get their Live Streamer Ultra HD for a lower price and still enjoy features such as variable refresh rate. So you can get the GC575 HDMI 2.1 model for around $269 and the Ultra HD GC571 model for around $179 on Amazon at the time of making this video. It's also available everywhere in the world. You simply need to go to their website to see the available stores in your country. It's backed by AVerMedia's 12-month warranty, and you can even apply for extended warranty. See the purchase links in the description below this video. So I've come to the end of this video. So to ensure that you get the original high quality electronics directly from AVerMedia and not from some third party seller who may try to scam you into purchasing fake products, the links in the description are provided directly from AVerMedia, and they are affiliate links, which means AVerMedia will pay me a small commission for each sale generated from using these links. So to be on the safe side, use the links I place in the description and support my channel at the same time, and thanks in advance for your support. If their products and the information contained in this video were of value, then give it the thumbs up to show some support, as it also helps me with the ratings. If you are viewing one of my videos for the first time, then do me a favor. Before leaving, click the subscribe button and ring the notifications bell to receive notifications when I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. Stay connected and see you in the next one.